How can we study together out of inclusion, like in this effort we make in the workshop, to try and make the same effort now during the study?
We don't see it, but we need to be this way. Just like when we read the Zohar in the evening lesson. We don't know where are we together or not together, but from above, they relate to the entire vessel in general, all of humanity, still vegetative and animate, all of creation as one Havaya. So to the extent that a person tries to be intermingled, integrated with this Havaya, by that he is closer to the upper light and he draws upon himself its illumination. It all depends on a person's effort. We don't know what we're reading about. These things are very exalted. Of course, we can make certain calculations in our minds. Hey, that's how it needs to be. Because it's, you know, in every science, it's like that. We learn about this and this and this, and then later, this plus that equals that, and this plus that equals that. But in spirituality, it doesn't work according to your intellectual calculations, but according to your attainment. The attainment has to do with a person's inner change. Therefore, to the extent that we try to be together, that is the change that needs to be. By that, we invite, from that state that we aspire to, from the effort to get there, accordingly, we invite upon ourselves this illumination, and it takes care of us, and it truly does the work, and it truly raises us, it advances us a step further, a step forward. And that's the whole trick. There's nothing special here. It's a force like we have, like any other force in this world, in various modes. It's called a skula, a remedy, a virtue, Torah, mitzvot. But in truth, it's also a remedy. Also, in our world, you could say it's a virtue, it's a remedy. But in truth, it is the same force.